Hey guys, so today is going to be a part two of my how I became a software engineer without a CS degree and without a bootcamp. This video is going to be just sort of answering a lot of the frequently asked questions I've gotten on Instagram and in the comment section, just to give you guys a little bit more detail about what this process was like for me. So I'll be coming in with real tea, no milk, and definitely no sugar, and let's get started. So before I even hop into the questions, I want to be honest with why I'm making this video. When I was starting this process, I thought it was going to be very straightforward, very clear cut, take the classes, learn how to program, I get a job. But I'm going to be honest with you that it's not like that at all. This journey, if you decide to go the self-taught route, will be very windy, very confusing, and mostly pretty uncomfortable. If you're someone who doesn't do well with uncertainty and needs to have a little bit more structure and needs to have like a set out plan for you, I would not recommend that you do the self-study route. Now let's hop into the most frequently asked questions. So the first question is at Recurse Center. So honestly, I loved Recurse Center and I definitely attribute it to me getting my first job, but I'm gonna be honest with you, Recurse Center is not for everyone. You're not guaranteed a job if you do the program. I think this program is really good for people who are in their like last leg of their journey. Like you're very confident in your ability to build projects, you know your data structures and algorithms, and you just want to find that last missing link that will connect you to a job. Then the Recurse Center, I think, is a good place to be. But if you're still in the beginning stages of your process, please do not apply to the Recurse Center. Don't do it. Because at the end of the day, if you're applying to the Recurse Center, it's gonna be a huge risk. Honestly, it's gonna be a huge risk, and you're not guaranteed a job. You're gonna be living in one of the most expensive cities in the country and making no money and basically just self-teaching, looking for a job. So only do Recurse Center when you are looking to just sort of close the loop and connecting all the things you learned to you getting a job. And also I would only do Recurse Center if you have a lot of money and savings, because you're going to be living in a very expensive city. So this is another popular question I got asked. What were the CS courses I took when I was in college? My freshman year, I took a Introduction to Computer Science course in Java. My sophomore year, I took a Object Oriented and Design course in Java 2. And then my senior year, I took a Data Analysis course in R. So only the first two courses were relevant to the journey that I took today. So, and those two courses were taken, like I said, way early in my college journey. So by the time when I decided to actually start applying for jobs, I still kind of had to start from scratch. So how long did the process take me? Like, I have friends who it took them like 2 years to go from self-taught to getting a job. So that's something to take into consideration when I tell you how long it took me to get my first job. So from deciding to take this journey to the end of this journey, it took about 9 months. The first 3 months I spent sort of self-studying before work. 2 hours a day I would self-study, sort of following the head first Java book that I mentioned in my last video and building small projects. After I quit my job, the next 3 months were spent at Recurse Center, and I was working full-time towards learning how to program, learning Python, taking a data structures and algorithms course, and just sort of building different projects. The last 3 months I was job hunting, lead coding, doing lead code and algorithm problems every single day, as well as sort of refining and making my projects a little bit better. So that was what I was doing the last 3 months. So another question I get asked is, how much money do I make? So I don't want to reveal my current salary right now, but I will be revealing it in a couple days. But just to give a little bit more overview about what my starting salary was at Recurse Center, they told me that as a junior engineer in New York City, you should expect to make between $70,000 to $100,000 as your starting salary. This was, of course, mind-blowing as someone who was making about $55,000 at her old job. So I got my only offer, which was the company I currently work at, and that offer was at $107,000, and I negotiated up to $113,000. So my starting salary after leaving the Recurse Center and after like 3 months of studying was $113,000, which was really great salary. So what do I do? I think this is a really interesting question because a lot of people who self-study might be wondering, like, what are the career paths and the specializations that you do after, like, you know, just sort of like learning on your own. A lot of people talk about like the front end, back end, and like full stack engineering roles, but there are also a lot of other fields, or there are a lot of specialties in software engineering that are outside of those roles that are not commonly talked about, but are actually still pretty lucrative and also pretty enjoyable too. So I think it's important to mention that there are a lot of other specialties outside of those that you can do even if you're self-taught. Like there's data engineering, where you manage the data ingestion and the data pipelines for the backend. There is testing, which you kind of build automated tests. There is infrastructure, which you manage like monitoring and deploying the different services that your company has. And then there's what I do, which is tools and applications. So I'm a software engineer in our internal tools and applications team. And what we're tasked with doing is sort of building tools for engineers. So our clients are other engineers. I've enjoyed doing what I've been doing. I've been there for about 2.5 years, and every single day I'm getting to program in Python, which is a lot of fun, but I'm also getting to learn new things. Like I learned a little bit about Kubernetes and a little bit about Docker. So another question I get asked is, how did I learn Python? Because like I said, I started first with Java and was able to sort of learn Python. It's not a far jump as you would think. I think if you, with a lot of languages, if you know one, you can, it's not too difficult to pick up other languages. But with Python, I really recommend this book and also this book. This book is Automate the Boring Stuff with Python. And I really loved this book. I thought it was really great for someone who enjoys project-based learning. I got to sort of like see the cool things that you could build with Python, and it got me really excited to keep learning more and more about Python. So I would definitely recommend this book. Another question I get asked is, what were the specific projects that I built while I was at the Recurse Center? I think this is another extremely important question because I think your projects do matter a lot in your interview process. So I built many projects, but I focused on three when I was interviewing. The first one was a text editor that I built from scratch. So, and I'll just actually link the prompt down below. So if you actually want to build this exact project, you can see like the starting points that I had when I was building the project down below. The second project that I built was a data visualization project. So I took IRS income data and then turned it into a data visualization. And it was basically an interactive map that sort of showed the different incomes per zip code. So you could sort of like hover through each zip code in New York City and see what the income was. And I also was able to sort of like map out 10 years of income data provided by the IRS. So that was a lot of fun sort of learning about Python's capabilities in building data visualizations. The last project I built was a small Flask application. So this application basically just gave you it was a restaurant recommendation application. So it was just pretty simple Flask application. So if you like this video, make sure to give this video a thumbs up and hit that subscribe button. If you have any other questions too, and you want me to like answer anything else, definitely leave those comments down below, and I'll see you guys next time.